Lying in my bed, I hear the clock tick and think of you. That was because I had been living with Dave Wolf. I lived in his studio apartment. I had some neighbors downstairs that I absolutely adored. Carl Eagleston came up and he looked at my apartment. He said, "You're not a white walls person and you have too much stuff in here." So he got rid of everything and he built a loft bed. So it was really like sleeping in a bird's nest. And also, when you figure that poor Dave Wolf, when he first met me, he must have been very determined, because not only did he have to climb up 5 flights of stairs, but then to get to bed, he had to climb up another flight of stairs. You know what I mean? And I had a clock that I really loved. I had got around the time of my birthday. And one night he climbed up and he knocked the clock over. And it's rolled, because, you know, it was a tenement, so it's on a tilt. So it rolled against the wall and smashed, right? And so then I was a little upset. So he said, "Don't worry about it." So he went back to his mother's and he gets an old clock. And it wasn't like a kind of clock like, you know, car wash from the 70s. No, like a really cool little thing. It was a white wind-up clock that was so loud I had to put it in the bathroom, because it was only one room. Put it in the bathroom and close the door. And you could still hear it. So you know that line, "Lying in my bed, I hear the clock tick and think of you"? No kidding. It's absolutely true, you know. So it was little things that we all were experiencing. I wanted to take bits of real life and put it in music. You have to be here now and take a piece of everything around you and use it to make music that people, real people, can hear and relate to, because they have the same stuff going on in their life. Drumming.